Now let's look at the last video on the topic of friction, and this is another question on flat pivot bearing. So the question says, a thrust shaft of a ship has six collars of 600 mm OD and 300 mm ID. That's outer dia and inner dia. The total thrust from the propeller is 120 kilonewtons. If the coefficient of friction is 0.15 and the speed of engine is 100 rpm, find the power lost in friction at thrust block, assuming uniform pressure and uniform wear. Now, data, your OD, let us say R2, radius would be 300 millimeters, that is equal to 0.3 meters. R1, that's the ID, it's 150 mm, that would be 0.15 meters. Okay, so the thrust given to you is 120 kilonewtons. Okay, the coefficient of friction is 0.15 and the RPM is 100. Okay, now with uniform pressure, we know the formula is, so we'll look at the formula for torque. So torque, this is for uniform pressure, this is mu W. Now this is going to be a hollow bearing, so this would be, or a hollow shaft, this would be R2 cube minus R1 cube by R2 square minus R1 square. Just plug in the values into 0.15 into 120 into 1000 into 0.3 cube minus 0.15 cube upon this minus this. Okay. So the answer comes out to be 4200 newton meters. That's the torque lost in friction, or to overcome friction. The power loss would be this torque into omega, that is 4200 into 2 pi into n is 100 upon 60, and let's divide this by 1000 to get kilowatts. So this would be almost 44 kilowatts. So this is for uniform pressure. For uniform wear, the torque to overcome friction is mu W into Rm by, not 2, just Rm. So this Rm is the mean radius. So your Rm would be 0.3 plus 0.15 upon 2. That is 0.225. So we'll put it in the formula. You will get 0.15 into 120 kilonewtons into 0.225. That gives you torque, which is 4050, and the power loss would be 4050 into 2 pi into 100 upon 60 T into omega. That gives you 42.41 kilowatts. So this is the power lost due to friction for uniform wear, and this is the power lost due to friction in uniform pressure. So I hope you understood this video and the entire chapter on friction. So make a note of all these formulas in the given chapter and practice the questions on this. So thanks for watching.